Hi, my name is Vivek and welcome to my YouTube channel. This is the sixth episode to create an e-commerce website using WooCommerce. In the previous episode, we work on Hero Carousel using Slick.js and custom post type UI. Today, we'll create old products and show my recent products using Slick.js. First of all, let's add some categories so that we can add some products. So open your admin panel, go to products and click on categories. Then write the name. I will write main. And if you have any image, then you can click on this upload button. Then click on add new category. Again, let's create another category called shoes. If you have image, you can click on the upload button and choose the image. Click on add new category. Then I will add one last category and I'll choose the image and click on add new category. Since all categories has been created, let's add a new product. So click on add new, then you can fill up all this information. So let's copy the title of this product. Also, this is where a long description is added, so I'll just paste it over here. And this is where the short description is added, so I will add my short description over here. Then you can see all the categories over here, and for this product I want to choose this category, and then the price, I want to add the price. So here in the regular price you can just add your own price, and then if you want to add some additional information like color or size, then you can click on this attribute and then click on add. Then you can write the name. So the first one is color, so I just want to write color, and then I want to add values over here. Then click on save attributes. If you want to create new, then again you can click on add, and this time I want to add size and add some value. Once done, click on save attributes. And in the future, if you want to change, then just click on them and you can just make some changes. And then if you want to add some image, then you can click on this product image and product gallery. So if you add in this product image, then it will show a bigger picture like this one. And then if you add images in this product gallery, then it will show images in a thumbnail like this one. So let's add some images. So I want to make this as my main image. Then I want to add two thumbnails So I'll just select two of them and click open. Also, if you want to add any tag, then you can write over here like this. Once done, you can click on add, and once all the information has been added, then you can click on this publish button. So your product is now published. If you want to view them, then you can simply click on this link. And you can see a product over here. Now I will pause my video and create all the remaining products. Okay, so I have created all the products now, and if you want to view them, you can go to admin panel and click on this all products. And here you can see a list of products that I have created. Now let's work on the code to show new products in home page. So open your home template, and just after this hero block you can create new section with a class called block, and this section I want to call new arrival block. Inside this section I want to add container div, and inside container div I want to add title in title holder div, and I want to add title inside s2 and this span. I'll just call it new arrivals, and I want to add some content like thousands of items added daily. So let's refresh the site now, and you should see a title and a content now. Then in order to show my recent product, we have to use WooCommerce shortcode. And if you want to find the shortcodes, then open your new tab and you can search for WooCommerce shortcodes. Then you can open this first link, and here in this page you can find shortcodes for different things like cards, checkout, my accounts and so on. But currently we need the shortcode for this product, and again inside this product we have got different shortcode for feature product or sale product or best-selling product and so on. And out of those shortcodes we need this recent product shortcodes. So you can copy this one and go back to your template file. You can open your PHP first, and you can type echo do underscore shortcode. So if you want to add shortcode in PHP, you have to follow this code and you have to add shortcode inside just like this one. Now let's refresh the site, and you should see my recent product in the home page. Here you go. But if we look at the design, instead of showing all the products, we are showing the products in this nice carousel. And to use the carousel, we will use a plugin called Slick.js. So in the new tab you can find for Slick.js, and then you can open the first link. Then click on demos, and I want to use this responsive display, so copy all of this code and you can paste it inside your main.js. I will remove these two unwanted breakpoints, and I don't need dots in my carousel, so I will remove this as well. And for this breakpoint, instead of 1024 I want to use 769, and in that breakpoint I just want to show two slides instead of three. Now I want to add new class called Slick.js over here, and then I want to use Slick.js and products in main.js. The reason for using this Slick.js class is to target more specific products only. In WooCommerce, most of the products like feature product or sale product or even shop page, they all use common class called products. Now refresh the site again. And you should see a nice carousel over here. Great. This is the end of this session. In the next session, we will display product categories using short code. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions. Also, please don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel to get more tutorials in the future. Thank you.